In this example, I'm going to describe the steps we would use to calculate the heat removal to condense a mixture of vapors to a liquid mixture at constant pressure. So I've shown a diagram of the type of calculation we'd like to do, where we have a vapor coming in. In this case, it's at its dew point. We want to have a liquid leaving at its bubble point. And what we're going to use is the idea of state function to do this calculation. The overall calculation is just delta H is equal to Q. And this is, for example, per mole of feed. And the question is, how do we account for the fact that there's interactions in the liquid phase, that the liquid's not ideal, whereas the vapor, the molecules, are not interacting? And so what I'll do is go through the steps of taking advantage of the idea of state function to do this calculation. First, let's look at what we're doing on a TXY diagram. So we're starting here. The inlet is at the bubble point. This is a constant pressure plot. Pure methanol here has a lower boiling point than pure water over here. And we're going from this inlet to this outlet. And the question is, what is the delta H, so therefore calculate Q. So we're going to be systematic about this and break it down using state function to a number of steps. The first step is, say, we will separate the gases into the pure gases. Well, reasonable to assume these are ideal gases, so delta H for this process would be zero. So delta H of mixing for ideal gases is zero. And then we're going to condense each of the species. We know the heat of vaporization for the pure components. So I've written down the condensed water, delta H, we're going to pick as our base is 1 mole. So we have 4/10 of a mole of water times minus delta H of vaporization for water. That will be delta H2. And this is at 80 degrees C, so we could look this up in the steam tables. And then the same thing for methanol, but we have 6/10 of mole of methanol minus delta H of vaporization of methanol, again at 80 degrees C, and then we need a source for this that we would have to look up somewhere. Our next step is to cool liquid water from 80 degrees to 70 degrees, because our outlet temperature is 70 degrees. Delta H4, then we have 4/10 of a mole times the heat capacity of liquid water, 70 minus 80. And then we can look this up in steam tables or use a constant heat capacity, which is a pretty good approximation for liquid small temperature range. And then we have the same thing for methanol. So I've written down the same calculation for methanol, and again, we have to find the heat capacity for methanol. Now we have the two pure liquids at 70 degrees. What we're going to do is mix them to get to our final condition at 70 degrees C. Well, there would be an enthalpy change if this is not an ideal solution. So delta H6, delta H of mixing, which we would need data that we'd have to look up somewhere to do this part of the calculation. And then our overall Q is our overall delta H, which is just the sum of the delta H's. And then we can substitute in for each of the values that we calculated. And then we can group together the methanol and the water term. And so we have our final answer. The heat removal to condense a mole of 60% methanol and 40% water. And we'd have to then look up heats of vaporization, heat capacities, and then the delta H of mixing allows this to account for the fact that the liquid's not going to be ideal. And so we can take advantage of state function to simplify the calculation significantly.